Hi, y'all. Here I am going to talk a little bit about the three different ways that the world views mental illness. In the next slideshow, we'll start to talk about how these different views that I'm going to discuss in this slideshow, how those views have waxed and waned throughout the history of the world. So I want to describe. First thing is, what is a mental illness? I mean, clearly I'm going to leave this for your abnormal psychology class far more than I am for your history class, but I just want to get it on track. It's mental illness there's no real good definition of mental illness. Personally, I mean, this is my own opinion. My definition of mental illness is behaviors that are not adaptive. You know, I'm a big evolutionary theorist, and I believe that by definition, human beings have a will to live, have a will to adapt, have a will to survive, and any behavior that runs counter to what I think would be our biological root would be considered a mental illness, right? But society doesn't necessarily label it that way, right? So society has to have a label for it. And we'll talk in more detail about the DSM and how we currently classify mental illness. But anyway, mental illness is, you know, behaviors that are harmful or unrealistic or inappropriate or unpredictable. And again, I mean, we'll talk in the next chapter about, you know, what, because society defines this and changes it with time. Well, anyway, there's three different models or three different ways to view mental illnesses. And these three different ways, as I said, in the next presentation, we'll kind of talk about how they've been presented throughout history. Sometimes one is more popular than another. And we find that these three different views of mental illness, all people have at least some degree of all three, with some people subscribing heavier to one of them than the other. The first model of mental illness is a very old one, actually, but it's gained a lot of favor in the modern world with the advent of psychotropic medications. But the medical model of mental illness basically says diseases are caused by a malfunctioning of some aspect of the body. Okay. In other words, a mental illness is really not any different than a physical illness. It's just that the cause of the disturbance is in the brain. And this goes way back, but the medical model of mental illness is interesting because it, let's see, it removes blame, all right? It's not my fault because I don't have control over it, so you can't blame me, okay? And so in some ways, it's good because, I mean, you want to blame somebody that's got a mental illness, it's your fault, whatever. Okay, we'll come back to that. But this model doesn't necessarily, you know, it says you can't control it. It just is. It's a biological disorder, okay? But it also connotes or implies that you can fix it, all right? It's something broken, and you can fix it. And the job of a physician or, in this case, a psychiatrist or a counselor or something would be to find what is broken and fix it, okay? Clearly, the medical model of mental illness is the primary belief system which is held by psychiatry, okay? And so many would in fact argue that in the modern world, psychiatrists are just like, what, you got a problem, drug it, done, okay? They think perhaps that drugs are the solution to the problem because that will fix the imbalance. The second approach to mental illness is actually probably the most recent, but there have been elements of this again throughout history. But the psychological model of mental illness basically says, look, and in fact, in a lot of ways, this goes back to Diogenes. Remember Diogenes? And he said, look, human beings are born somehow perfect. And if it was natural, it'd be good. But what happens is the world that we're forced to live in stresses us out. And remember, in fact, Diogenes had said some things such as, if you look at the negative emotions like anger or jealousy or something like that, these negative emotions can only exist because of the presence of other people. So mental illness is caused by the stress of living in an organized society. Okay. Now, don't get me wrong. I mean, nobody says completely, oh, I have a psychological belief in mental illness. I mean, everybody's going to balance these out. But the psychological model is a pretty popular model nowadays, especially in the field of counseling. Okay? Counseling and counselors are probably most apt to say this is the way that they view mental illnesses. But on top of all of that, there's a third one. It's one that nobody wants to really talk about because it's like that little skeleton in the closet of psychology. And that's a supernatural model of mental illness. And this is a belief that mental abnormalities, I mean, unless you can find an obvious physical cause, are caused by mysterious forces entering the body, demons or something like that. And we're going to find that the supernatural model of mental illness at different times in history was the dominant way that people viewed mental illness. But even to this day, there's still at least some thought of the supernatural model. Now, in other parts of the world, not West, and it still dominates. You know, in some parts of the world, you say, somebody is experiencing a hallucination. Why do you think that's happening? And then they'll say, oh, demons are possessing them. It's like, okay, you know what? This is 2000 something. I want to keep my videos relevant for the next time I want to teach a class. So it's 2000 and something. All right. And yet we still have some of this supernatural model. And in this supernatural, because, I mean, it's sort of like cosmic karma or something. That is to say, mental illness is caused by you did something wrong, or you deserved it, or you did something and God is mad at you and this is your punishment. Now, most of us in the West do not use this as our main perspective on mental illness, but it does form at least part of our perspective. Now, as I said, when you get to the extremes, okay, we're going to find points in history where the supernatural model of mental illness was the dominant view. We're going to find points in history where the medical model was the dominant view. We're going to find points in history where the psychological model of mental illness was the dominant view. And yet we're going to find that throughout there, it's never been one or the other. Okay, including here in modern times, we are more likely to subscribe to a combination of medical and psychological, but we're never really totally discarding the supernatural. Well, these different views of mental illness, just like anything, what sometimes happens is that there is conflicts. I mean, as we know, there's conflicts between evolution and religion, and conflicts between conservatives and Republicans. Well, these conflicts are often caused by the fact that people view the world as black and white, all or none, okay? And so we find that there's a whole group of wackos. Shall we call them wackos? That's not Tom Cruise, okay? There's a whole group of wackos, and yes, Scientologists are one of them wackos, that truly believe that there is no such, that mental illness is fake. It's made up. It's a psychological construct. They say, look, people may suffer problems in living, but not mental illness. The word mental illness is a societal invention. And in fact, a societal invention, which if you believe, right, and I mean, there's a grain of truth here, but if you believe, is used as an act of control. I mean, if everybody knows that hysteria is, by definition, hyster is the Latin word for uterus, and hysteria was felt to be a woman thing, right? A woman thing caused by movement of the uterus or bad movements of the uterus, and clearly it was used as a way to control women. So, in a lot of ways, what people hear, in fact, this is Thomas Saz over here with Tom Cruise. What a surprise. Tom Cruise, Mr. Scientology, man, you know, going up with Thomas Saz. They say mental illness is a myth. It's made up. It's fake. Society invents it to control people that they don't like, okay? You can have a problem with living, but there's no such thing as mental illness. And just because you have a weird belief system doesn't mean you're wrong. Okay, and if you have some abnormal behaviors or something, it's not you, it's not your fault, it's the society you come from, right? So, as I was saying, these three different views of mental illness have always lived side by side. Three different perspectives on mental illness have always lived side by side, not always harmoniously. And so in the next presentation, I'm going to come back and talk about how these perspectives have waxed and waned throughout history. All right, I'll see you then.